Guys, welcome back to my channel. This is part two of the part one series of what is called Tea Time. The reason there is a part two, you don't have to watch part one if you don't feel comfortable. It is just basically I wanted to start a series that I will do every once in a while where I have some tea. And some possibly food. You can see that I was already using the cream cheese, but I have another half of a bagel to eat for you guys, just for some, you know, sounds, some mouth sounds. Here's the cream cheese. But like I said, this is part two, which is basically the point of the part one. Where I talk about my anxiety and depression. I already talked about my anxiety and depression, like what caused it in part one, and it is a pretty tough subject for some people. It was sexual abuse and the death of my father, which I referred to the video called Losing a Parent, which explains the death of my father. And now here is the part where I tell you guys how to deal with anxiety and depression after I tell you what caused it. So I thought while I was doing that, I would brush your hair while I'm eating and drinking, and maybe just brush your face a little bit. I was already doing it in the last video, but again, if you guys, some of you are bothered by sexual abuse and things like that, just stick around for this story and I'm gonna do the same exact thing I was doing last video, only here are my tips for anxiety and depression. Okay, so let's jump right in and get to eating. Okay, so I've got my cream cheese here. Moving on, with my story, finishing up with my story. So, I was thrown into labor early after my father died. My daughter was 2 weeks premature, and it caused, like I said, I was having anxiety attacks to where it was just putting me in basically a small coma. I felt like I was going to die. Whenever you have anxiety attacks, some people, such as myself, what will happen is I get this very, like, hot, uncomfortable, tingly feeling. For those out there who have ever done drugs before and you are familiar with the drug salvia, for those, like I said, who are familiar with that drug, whenever you smoke it, whenever the come on begins, it's like a very uncomfortable hot feeling, like you want to take your clothes off. And that's the feeling I get. That's how I know I'm gonna get an anxiety attack, is my skin will start tingling and my heart will start racing, and it, like, seeing, like, my vision becomes, I become very delusional and I can't see around me. Things become very hard to pay attention to. So anyway, fast forward up to today, where I'm getting help for all that. One thing I realized that really helps with anxiety, or let's start with depression, one thing that helps, and I know, oh, just pausing really quick, I warn this in every video, I do not eat like this in real life. It's for the video. So, depression. I know this sounds cliche, but number one, in my opinion, talk to somebody. All my life, I have suppressed my depression, I have suppressed my anxiety and my memories. The first step to healing, in my opinion, with depression is just talking to somebody who will listen. If you cannot find somebody who will listen, I will link to you guys below a hotline that you can call any time of the day and they will listen to you. It's not a suicide hotline, but it's close to it. There are many times in my life that I've contemplated suicide for real because of how bad it got, and I just didn't want to talk to anybody because I thought nobody would listen. That's why I'm always replying to you guys and caring, because I genuinely want to hear your stories and I want to, you know what I mean? Like, I want to talk to you guys and stuff like that. So, the second thing that I do when I'm depressed is I'm not a very big music listener. I rarely listen to music, and the reason for that is because, number one, I feel that music is very repetitive. I feel like I'm very into, like, drum and bass. Now, there's a difference between drum and bass and dubstep. I do not like dubstep. I like drum and bass. And that's rare that I listen to any of it. I like trance. And my favorite band, for those of you who know me, is Radiohead. I have 3 tattoos dedicated to Radiohead / Thom Yorke. Anyway. But when I'm depressed, honestly, I try to find my favorite, you know, music that doesn't have negative memories. And that's another reason I don't listen to music, is because of just memories that I don't want to go back to. Although I like the song, I don't like the memory, which will come up no matter what. You know, your brain is connected to that memory, which is connected to the song. So. Well, listen to music. And it helps. I don't recommend this third tip. But that is, I take a nap. Which, I read that that's actually suppressing memories even worse. But it helps me. I wake up feeling a little bit better. But there are days that I'll go to sleep and I'll wake up feeling worse. For example, I will not take a nap during the evening if I'm feeling depressed, because waking up in the dark is the worst feeling. It hurts my heart. Like, it makes me wake up and wish I was dead, pretty much. But yeah, the biggest thing, in my opinion, is to talk to somebody. I go to counseling 1 hour a week. I have a counselor who loves me as a person, likes me as a person. She gives brilliant advice, and she lets me vent. You need to vent. Whoever you are, when you're depressed, man, venting and crying, that's my next tip. Just cry. I know that sounds so bad, but you can't tell me that after you cry, you don't feel a little bit better. Like, even though the sorrow and depression and hurt is still in your heart, you feel that sense of just, like, waking up. Like, you feel that sense that you just got something off your chest. And like I said, feeling emotion. When my dad died, I suppressed everything. You want to feel that pain. It makes you stronger. That might sound very strange, but I'm telling you right now, if you cry, if you just let it out to somebody who you trust or on the phone to that hotline. Sorry about that. Oh my gosh. There is stuff all over my lips. Why didn't you guys tell me? No, I'm kidding. No, but a garbage truck just like casually stopped right outside my house and I just like got so angry. Anyway, if you just cry and let it out and, you know, just talk to somebody, you know, I promise you will feel better. Now, moving on to anxiety. Whenever I get an anxiety attack, I told you guys how I feel. It makes you feel like you want to take your clothes off. You're delusional. You feel like you are going to die. Like, that sounds so grim, but like the feeling, I'm telling you, if you have ever had a very severe crippling anxiety attack, like that's why they call it crippling, is because you are on the floor, like I am telling you. So, they say that you can heal your body. They did a study in a foreign country, I'm not exactly sure, where, the Philippines, I believe. Now, they did a study where they, had a little medicine shop and they took vials, and on the vial it said heal your cancer, like it was severe, like it was like heal your cancer, heal your AIDS, like heal your wounds, just, you know, things like that. But it was very large issues and it was a very small vial, and these people would pay like $50, like in the Philippines that's a lot of money, and they would drink it and they would heal, like, immediately, like, in the first, you know, few weeks, like, they'd be completely cured of, like cancers, you know what I mean? And it turns out the vials were water, just straight up tap water from the sink. Like, they just took tap water, and it's called the placebo effect. Now, I know this sounds crazy, and I know this sounds like spiritual bullcrap or whatever you want to call it, but when I start to get an anxiety attack, what I'll do is, in my head, I stop it. Now, I know that sounds so weird, but in my head, like, I'll feel it coming on, and in my head, I'm just like, nope, it's done. It's not even gonna happen, and I'll start getting up and pacing. I'll do whatever it takes. Like, you really gotta believe it. Like, I'm not saying anything, like, rude towards Christians, but Christians, they're really for their God, and they believe it no matter what. Now, I believe that I can stop my anxiety attack, and, like, 98% of the time it happens. Sometimes it's just too bad, but another thing I do is called the 4-7-8 method. Now, the 4-7-8 method is breathe in for 4 seconds, and that's actually going to be my next ASMR video, it's going to be a guided sleep meditation. Now, breathe in for 4 seconds, hold for 7. And then exhale for 8 seconds. Now, whenever you're having an anxiety attack, sometimes that becomes very hard. So if you can't, you know, get the numbers right, that's fine. Like, you know, you can only do the best you can. But I know, like, all of these tips, when they say just to breathe during your anxiety attack, I think to myself, I'm like, that is so typical, like breathing and talking it out and things like that. Like, I always thought that was so dumb and just not very helpful, but it has really changed my life, that method, you know what I mean? Like, I feel so much better when I do it, and even though I'm still, you know, having the anxiety, it really helps a lot in my opinion. So that's another tip for my anxiety.
Oh my god, that's a big bite. So, there's the 4-7-8 method. Other than that, my best advice to you, if you heard that noise, is to literally, like with depression, talk and cry and feel that emotion. I will leave the number down in the description. And I will also leave a link to the 4-7-8 method. It really, really, really helps. At least it helps me, and what my goal is to just try to help you guys. So, I hope you enjoyed this very small video. Like I said, this is just an experiment. This isn't like something where I'm like, well, this is today's video. You know what I mean? Like, this will be called tea time, and like I said, I will be having some tea. This tea is actually, oh my gosh, look at that. That is filthy. That is just horrible. This is Tetley's black tea. My mother's mother, my Bubba. In my other video, I explain I'm like German, Polish, and Irish, so Bubba, Polish. I explain that I spent a lot of time when I was younger at her house, so she used to make me this tea. One tea bag of black Tetley tea, 3 teaspoons of regular sugar, and you fill it up to about here. You can see the line, and then you fill it up the rest after it steeps for 4 minutes with vitamin D milk. I mean, I'm trying very hard not to drink milk anymore, but whatever. So I'll be having some tea, having some food, you see all over my face, which is very gross, and just talking about certain things. Now, I know that this one was a little bit grim, especially if you watch part one, but like I said, this channel is a positive place where you can come and relax and hopefully enjoy these sounds and enjoy me just, you know, brushing your face and just talking and trying to do my best to help you guys. You know what I mean? You guys helped me, so I want to return the favor. And I am so sorry about these cars, man. Like, I live right on the road. And when I replay the video, I can't hear it, but still. It just bothers me when I hear the So thank you guys so much for watching. And if you have any suggestions or constructive criticism, please let me know. Because I want to make this series a once in a while thing, but I want it to be very relaxing. Obviously, the topic today wasn't very relaxing, but hey, you gotta start somewhere, you know? So, thank you so much. I love you guys with all of my being, and I will see you guys next time.